My dear Shilpa, I always known her for promoting initiatives for the growth of the society, improvement of the society, and I remember her associated with Roshni and one para-athletic for physically handicapped. And also one more thing, with something to do with weaves and clothes.
Yes, that was handlooms for sustainable fashion. And the sustainable living channel that she started talking about sustainable lifestyles.
Yeah, we talked about it.
We did.
We talked about sustainable lifestyles there.
Yeah.
Fantastic, Shilpa. And now, along with Kanti Dutt, you have started this Sustain Cart.
That is Life's Conscious Choices for Sustainable Living.
Yes.
It has a wide range of products and they're launching this pan-India.
Yeah, and I'm pan-India, and I heard you can find all these products in one single place.
Yeah.
This is fantastic. Shilpa, we are proud of you.
So proud of you.
And for giving us the honor of launching this Sustain Cart, I thank you. We thank you. And so, Sustain Cart is launched.
Yep. Launched, and wish you all the very best.
God bless you, Shilpa.
Hello, everyone. First of all, I want to thank you all from the bottom of my heart for showering upon us so much love. We started this endeavor with our YouTube channel, Sustainable Living with Shilpa Reddy, and we felt the need to share our story, how it all began, before we venture into something beautiful which would impact lives in the most positive way. So, Kanti, so this has been on my mind for a long time, but I wanted to ask you now, why did you bring this venture to me and why did you sketch out this beautiful plan called Sustainable Living with Shilpa Reddy?
So like anybody else, I also felt the need during the lockdown that we all should take a step towards protecting nature. Mm. And I've known you for quite some time now, and I know the kind of activities you indulge in and the way you carry yourself. So connecting these dots, I felt that we taking something into a larger space to impact on the larger front will definitely make sense at this point of time. And sustainability is just so you, and I've known a lot of them around who keep talking about the good deeds we need to indulge ourselves in. Mm-hmm. But there are only a few who actually practice them before they ask people around them to do so.
So you're saying I'm one of those?
Oh yeah, of course you are.
Thank you.
You are, absolutely. And I know the kind of activities you do on a day-to-day basis, those little steps you started off with, right from carrying your own steel bottle to that of forcing me to do so, in fact, preaching me to do so. So these little things I felt will actually add a lot of value in the long run. Mm. And it is definitely the need of the hour for somebody to step up and make people realize the need to protect and conserve Mother Earth.
Oh, thank you. This is like a big compliment that you've given to me.
My pleasure.
So Kanti, like you rightly said, I had the passion and I was doing it through my social media platform, and your planning, my passion, and how you kind of put out this plan of, you know, doing it in a big way, wherein our voices are heard to a larger audiences. That really excited me. So when you presented me with this idea, it immediately resonated with me, because that's what I was doing, but I was doing it in a smaller scale. And this vision was much larger than I ever envisioned. And it made sense to, you know, speak out loud and educate people from a larger platform. Not just that, that was also the time when everything slowed down, and I thought I must make use of my time in the most productive way, not just for myself, but also to a larger audience. Again, for a subject which is the need of the hour, and which was again I was passionate towards. So I jumped in.
So like you said about the time in life, I think it was very similar to that of I was in. Because I wanted to do something more gratifying than just media business. So I was also looking at opportunities where it's not just about money or reaching out to larger audience, but also self-gratification point that I was personally as well looking at. And I think that was the right time we dived into this project. And by God's grace, everything came into one right spot so quickly.
So quickly, let me tell you.
Very quickly, in fact. And then everybody around us appreciated our efforts and helped us carve this into a more professional, systematic and responsible venture.
Absolutely.
But I remember as we started off, there were a lot of brands who started ringing me up because everybody knows I was in the back end and you were heading it on the front of it.
Right.
So they started asking me if they could be a part of the venture, if we could help them reach to the right clientele.
You won't believe, I got so many emails as well, and on Instagram, right. Facebook, so...
The messages and
yes,
requests, right?
Absolutely, yeah.
So when I saw a lot of them approaching us, but by then I'm sure we have already roped in few brands.
Correct.
Very conscious and responsible brands.
That's right.
That we wanted to take to the audience.
Right.
But I couldn't understand or visualize about how we could connect the rest of the brands to the platform that we created.
So if you remember, Kanti, a few posts I had made about what all I've incorporated into my life to make it more sustainable. Like whether it's, you know, the steel jars in my kitchen or bottles or, you know, the scrubs that I use to wash the dishes. The number of queries I was getting as to, you know, people asking me as to where I bought every single product.
You're right. Yeah.
I couldn't answer most of them because there were too many.
Right. So I think connecting these two dots, we truly saw the need.
Right.
Where there are audience who want us to connect them to a platform that caters to conscious, responsible products.
Right.
On the other hand, when we talk about the e-commerce marketplace businesses in the market already, I should say it's very difficult to pick choose the right product that is sustainable, biodegradable.
Because they're scattered all over the place, right? Yeah.
So, even I remember there were a lot of people who were writing on the comments section about where they could buy all the products you made posts about.
Correct.
So that's where I think we resonated with each other about the idea to start India's first ever e-commerce marketplace for sustainable products.
Yes.
And bring together all the conscious brands across India to one platform.
Right.
And also help them reach out to their right clientele. By right clientele, I mean the conscious consumers, people who are responsible towards nature.
Willing to be responsible.
Absolutely. And
wanting to be responsible.
If you remember, I think it's been 4 months we started off with Sustainable Living Show. And in every video, if you see, there are comments in the comment section that say, I love the video, but not just that, they also add saying, we want to make changes. I started buying products that are more sensible.
Right.
Or they add saying, they started using products at their offices or at their residences that are more responsible and conscious.
You should, I don't know if I mentioned this, there was this, you know, young girl holding a bamboo toothbrush and she sent me a picture saying this is my first step towards sustainable living. So it's so gratifying. So that's just a beginning, and I'm sure if we create a place like this, we were sure and I'm still very sure that this will resonate with a lot of people, and the timing is right. People are changing and they want to, you know, be conscious towards our planet and conscious towards the choices that they're making. So hope this comes together beautifully, and it did come together beautifully as we speak, but just want you know, people to receive it beautifully.
I am sure it will be, also because if you remember, it's been 3 months with the research and development we have been doing on this new venture, and everybody who we reached out to started asking them if this could sustain in the market and if this could have its own space in terms of the business model.
Right.
And if you remember, everybody said it was a great idea, it was the need of the hour.
That's
and
right.
We need to take a step towards something larger than life, something more meaningful. And I'm sure if a sustainable model like any other e-commerce platform today I'm sure they all sell lakhs of products each day.
Right.
And if we understand the need of the hour and if we make people realize the importance to buy the right products, I am sure there will be an immediate shift of where they start buying their commodities.
That's the hope. And also I want to, you know, mention to the viewers that we are also trying to bring a lot of handloom weavers and right. Indian artifacts and arts to the mainstream marketplace, wherein the middlemen are avoided and the artists and artisans have a direct connection with their clientele and could probably showcase their merchandise without, you know, middlemen or eliminating the middlemen. I hope this takes off because that's something very close to my heart.
Also, when you mentioned, I remember me reaching out to few handicraft businesses in the typical root level.
Right.
They just need certain guidance and help to take their business to the next level.
Mm.
I mean, more professionally. And they are happy to learn, happy to change the way they look at things, because we are at the end of the day trying to tell them we are eradicating the middlemen, helping them gain larger amount of profit.
That's right.
And also give them that kind of visibility they need as artisans.
Kanti, the most important thing I want to mention to people who are watching this is that people think sustainable lifestyle is for the affluent lot. Only someone who has loads of money, they can afford to live a sustainable life.
That's the myth.
That is the myth. We want to break that myth with this venture. I want everyone also to know that at our e-commerce website, there will be products ranging from kitchenware to garden tools to skincare to haircare for all price points.
Absolutely. So I also remember instructing our team to ensure we bring on board brands that could cater to audience across all price points and all kinds of lifestyles.
That's right.
And it was not easy, to be honest, but there is a constant effort being made by the team and also by us to bring in products that could actually cater to everybody at all price points. Having said that, not degrading the quality of the product.
If you are a sustainable brand and a conscious consumer, you now have a perfect platform to go to. We would love to have you on board and make you part of SustainCart family.
Today, the 1st of Jan 2021, we, the founders of SustainCart, made a conscious resolution to change the way people spend towards their lifestyle commodities. Changing their spending pattern is our prime motive.
We envision to revamp the households towards sustainable living with this venture. Lots and lots coming your way, so stay tuned for more updates. Please subscribe to our channel. Signing off, Shilpa Reddy.